Thou hast it now. King. Cawdor. Glamis. All is the weird woman promised, and I fear thou placed most foully for it. Yet, it was said it should not stand in thy posterity, but that myself be root to many kings. If there come truth from them, as upon thee, Macbeth, their speeches shine, why, by their verities may good, may they not be my oracles as well? Set me up in hope. But hush, no more.
Ah, here is our chief guest.
If he had been forgotten, it had been as a gap in our great feast and all thing unbecoming.
Tonight we hold a solemn supper, sir, and I'll request your presence.
Let your highness command upon me to which my duties are with the most indissoluble tie forever in it.
Ride you this afternoon?
Aye, my good lord.
We should else have desired your good advice, which still hath been both grave and prosperous in this day's council. What will we take tomorrow? Is it far you ride?
As far, my lord, as will fill up the time, twixt this and supper. Go not my horse about, I must become a borrower of the night for a dark hour or twain.
Fail not our feast?
My lord, I will not.
We hear our bloody cousins are bestowed in England and in Ireland, not confessing their cruel parasite, filling their hearers with strange invention. But of that tomorrow, when therewithal we shall have cause of state craving us jointly. Hide to horse, till you return at night. Adieu. Our ghost, Fleance, with you?
Aye, my good lord.
I wish your horses swift and sure of foot, and so I do commend you to their backs. Farewell.
Our time does call upon us.
Let every man be master of his time till 7 at night. To make society the sweeter welcome, we will keep ourselves till supper time alone. Well then, God be with you. To be thus is nothing, but to be safely thus. Our fears in Banquo stick deep, and in his royalty of nature reigns that which would be feared. 'Tis much he dares, and under him my genius is rebuked, as it is said Mark Antony's was by Caesar. He chid the sisters when first they put the name of king upon me and bade them speak to him. Then, prophet-like, they hailed him father to a line of kings. Upon my head they placed a fruitless crown and put a barren scepter in my gripe, thence to be wrenched with an unlineal hand, no son of mine succeeding. If it be so, for Duncan have I murdered, for Banquo's issue have I fired my mind, put rancors in the vessel of my peace, only for them, and mine eternal jewel given to the common enemy of man to make them kings. The seed of Banquo, kings? Rather than so, come fate into the list and champion me to the utterance. Was it not yesterday we spoke together?
It was, so please your highness.
Well then, now have you considered of my speeches? Know that it was he, in times past, which held you so under fortune, which you had thought had been our innocent self. This I made good to you in our last conference.
You made it known to us.
I did so, and went further, which is now our second point of meeting. If you have a station in the file, not in the worst rank of manhood, say it, and I will put that business in your bosoms, whose execution takes your enemy off, grapples you to the heart and love of us, which in our health was sickly in his life.
I am one, my liege, whom the vile blows and buffets of the world have so incensed that I am reckless what I do to spite the world.
And I another, so weary with disaster, tug with fortune that I would set my life on any chance to mend it or be rid on it.
Both of you know Banquo was your enemy?
True, my lord.
So is he mine. And in such bloody distance that every minute of his being thrusts against my nearest of life. And though I could, with barefaced power, sweep him from my sight and bid my will avouch it, yet I must not. Thence it is that I to your assistance do make love.
We shall, my lord, perform what you command us.
Though our lives...
Your spirits shine through you. Within this hour at most, I will advise you where to plant yourselves, for it must be done tonight and something from the palace. Fleance, his son that keeps him company, must embrace the fate of that dark hour. Resolve yourselves apart, I'll come to you anon.
We are resolved, my lords.
I'll come to you straight, abide within. It is concluded. Banquo, thy soul's flight, if it find heaven, must find it out tonight.